This Gaia. Not today. Today I want to talk about this guy's predecessor, La Pucelle Tactics. A strange title for a game with a strange combination of themes, namely food, religion, and breasts. La Pucelle was sold a year after its successor in the West to a very small publisher that decided on an odd bit of censorship. All references to crosses were removed, as were Croix cigarettes, so now he just makes strange hand gestures. To their credit, the game's plot was left alone, as was the series' goofy, immature humor. La Pucelle translates into the Maiden, which has some bearing on the plot and is likely a reference to Joan of Arc. In fact, the naming conventions in this whole game are fascinating. If it's not a French word for something religious, or you know, breast, then it's probably food. Father Salade, Princess Eclair, Mayonnaise Harbor. I'm still not sure why everything is food. The regular enemy names are even more interesting. They have a big list of words and titles that they randomly mash together with a Oh god! If you played Final Fantasy Tactics, or of course any of the Skya games, you have a pretty solid understanding of the gameplay already. Move around a grid and hit things. You can see early iterations of staple Disgaea elements like combos and team attacks, and you take turns as a team rather than each individual moving in order. But you go into this weird battle screen for each attack, and it doesn't do much but slow fights down. Like Disgaea, there's a lot of depth, and you can grind to stupid high levels, but there isn't nearly as much endgame content as in those titles. The only thing I really couldn't stand was these dark portals that randomly litter every map and endlessly spawn more enemies. A lot of systems are built around them, but I found it a constant annoyance. Graphically, it's your typical Nippon Ichi game. Basic, but very charming. Just look at these hand-drawn breast physics. There really is no good music to speak of, but there is some surprisingly competent voice acting. Especially the main character, Priye, who's voiced by Jennifer Hale.
You suck!
Probably best known for her work as Commander Shepard. Priye is an interesting character. Not exactly complex, but there's more to her than a lot of other Nippon Ichi characters. She proclaims to be the next Maiden of Light, while simultaneously being hot-tempered, self-centered, and often critical of her own religion. She constantly butts heads with her other teammates, especially her little brother Kulat and the far more pious Alouette. The story is character-driven and hard to nail down without spoiling anything. It's pretty cliche and predictable, but the characters are enjoyable enough to get you through, despite their annoying inner monologues. And the tone is all over the place, from really dumb to surprisingly dark. Every chapter can actually end in a couple of very different ways, but getting the good ending is sometimes dependent on performing a few very arbitrary actions, and you probably need a guide to figure it all out. In general, it's not quite so tongue-in-cheek as Disgaea, but it has a similar sense of humor and doesn't take itself too serious. There's even a hilarious secret ending where Priye becomes so powerful they make her into a demon overlord. You won't be getting this ending by accident, but it might actually be canon, as demon overlord Priye has made a cameo in just about every Disgaea game as either a secret boss or a DLC character. The game was re-released in Japan on the PSP, with lots of new features and even a whole mode for demon Priye. There was no English release, but there is a fan-made translation. So while it doesn't hold up to a lot of other turn-based strategy RPGs, it is still worth a playthrough. Just know that it is a little rough around the edges. The PS2 version is currently available on the PlayStation Network for $9.99.